Hello everyone, you're watching Physio Classroom channel, and in today's video we are going to practically demonstrate the gross testing procedures recommended by Broomstrom to evaluate sensory loss in hemiplegia patients. The three important components of gross sensory testing that were chosen by Broomstrom are kinesthesia evaluation, that is awareness of the joint movement in the paralytic upper and lower limb, tactile localization, that is localization of the touch in the paralytic hand, and pressure sensations in the sole of the foot. Now it is very important for a physiotherapist to have a fair idea about the affection of these sensory components in a hemiplegic patient before the therapy plan is designed, because the normal sensory inputs and sensory processing is an important key factor for normal motor output. Now this is so because only after the sensory inputs are processed and analyzed at the cortical level, a purposeful motor output can be expected. Many a times it can be a possibility that the sensory deficits are more as compared to the motor ones. And in such a situation, if the therapy is solely administered towards improving motor performance without paying attention towards the sensory re-education, the therapy can have poor outcomes. Therefore, it becomes important to assess these sensory components in a stroke or a hemiplegic patient. So let's start with the practical demonstration of these sensory testings. For kinesthesia testing in upper limb, the patient is made to sit on a chair and the physiotherapist now supports the affected upper limb of the patient and moves it in different position while the patient is asked to observe the movement and perform identically with the unaffected upper limb. While moving the affected upper limb passively in different directions, the physiotherapist makes a quick assessment to determine whether any painful movements are present. Also, the therapist obtains valuable information regarding the grade of spasticity present in different joints by analyzing the resistance offered to passive movement. After the patient has fully understood about the testing procedure, he or she is blindfolded and the actual test is performed. The affected upper limb is now moved passively by the therapist into new positions involving movements of the shoulder, elbow, forearm, and wrist joints. The therapist takes utmost care and ensures that painful movements and the stretching of spastic muscles to the point where resistance is felt are avoided during the testing. The blindfolded patient is asked to copy the movement on the other side by moving the unaffected upper limb in order to indicate the change in joint position that has taken place on the affected side. Marked difference in the joint positioning between the two sides indicates impaired kinesthetic and proprioceptive sensations. The therapist now checks for the kinesthetic and proprioceptive sensation in the fingers of the hemiplegic hand. The patient's forearms are pronated and made to rest on a firm pillow in the lap. The hands are placed in such a manner that the fingers are protruding over the edge of the pillow. The therapist now passively moves the fingers of the hemiplegic hand at the metacarpophalangeal joint in the flexion and extension direction. The patient is asked to indicate
when the finger motion is felt by telling its direction as up or down. Inability to sense the finger motion or its position in space indicates an impaired kinesthetic and proprioception sense. The therapist now checks for the tactile localization sense. For this, the patient's hands are positioned in the lap on a firm pillow as before. The therapist now uses a cotton wisp to deliver light touch sensation on the palmar surface of each of the fingertips in an irregular manner. The patient is asked to determine which fingertip is being touched.
Failure to point out the correct finger that has been touched indicates an impaired tactile localization sense. The therapist next checks for the kinesthesia sensations in the lower limb in a similar manner to that of the upper limb. The test is administered with the patient in supine lying and the unaffected lower limb placed in a position so that the hip and knee are flexed and the sole of the foot is in contact with the supporting surface. The therapist now passively moves the affected lower limb in different directions and the patient is asked to copy the movement with the unaffected side. Any marked difference in the joint positioning between the two sides indicates an impaired kinesthetic sensation in the lower limb. In the end, the therapist now checks for the pressure sensation in the sole of the foot. The patient is made to sit on a chair with both feet resting on the floor. A narrow flat object such as a spatula or the handle part of a spoon is used in the test. The object is first shown to the patient and then the patient is asked to determine whether or not the object has been placed against the sole of the foot, all the way across the ball of the foot in a side-to-side direction, or against only the medial side of the foot, or against only the lateral side of the foot. The test is first conducted on the unaffected side. The patient remains blindfolded and the therapist places the flat object under the foot in a random manner. The therapist now exerts a downward pressure from the patient's knee towards the foot to stimulate weight bearing. The patient is now asked to identify the manner in which he or she appreciates the object under the foot. The therapist next checks for the sole sensation on the affected side in a similar manner, and the findings are compared. Inability to appreciate the object under the foot or the position of the object indicates impaired pressure sensation.
So these were the important sensory tests that are recommended by Brunstrom to carry out in a hemiplegic patient. This enables the therapist to have a fair idea about the involvement of sensory components and its role in patients' poor motor performance. In our upcoming videos of Brunstrom therapy series, we will be covering many exercises that are based on the Brunstrom concept and that can be utilized to gain movement recovery in hemiplegia patient. Do keep motivating us with your comments and feedback and see you in our next video. Till then, keep learning, keep sharing and stay connected.